Damn, that was so sick. Watching Lamb of God on a small stage like that, man, I need to experience one of those shows of Lamb of God. Actually, I have one time, and it was in Brooklyn, and that's when Randy jumped out into the crowd and broke his collarbone. I was at that show. I was like, the dude just freaking broke his collarbone. And I remember a fan from the audience getting up and singing a couple of Lamb of God songs, and we were all blown away by that. But welcome back to the Metal Stream of the Year. Luckily, at that House of Band show in Chicago, Randy didn't break any bones, man. I feel like Randy has gotten healthier over the years performing on stage, and I think his jumps have gotten a lot higher. My name's Jose, Metal Ambassador Mangan, honored to be here hosting the Metal Stream of the Year. We should have been hosting the Metal Tour of the Year at venues across North America. There was 55 shows, and as you know, because of the pandemic, we had to postpone to next year. But the Metal Tour of the Year is still happening, featuring Lamb of God and Megadeth and Trivium and In Flames, all four amazing bands and bands that we fully support 24/7 over on SiriusXM, man. So check it out. Don't forget to follow my dumb ass. I'm on Instagram, Cameo, and Twitter. Come on, I got to do some shameless self-promoting too, right? At Jose Mangan. Hit me up on there. I'm very active, and you know, as you, I hope, know, I'm just a big fan of this music. Very blessed to be doing all this stuff. And the coolest thing about my life in this world is my idols have become my friends. And I love, you know, doing this here with you. So thank you very much for joining me. Don't forget, limited edition Metal Tour of Next Year shirts are available for a small amount of time. You can go to metaltouroftheyear.com to get your limited edition shirts now. There's also other cool merchandise in that web store. And we are donating a portion of the proceeds to Live Nation's Crew Nation, which is a global relief fund that is helping the live working crew, all the roadies, all the badasses that are behind the scenes that go to make shows happen. They're so important, and without them, we couldn't do shows, and you couldn't attend shows. So that's the thing. So really cool to be supporting Crew Nation. And don't forget, remember that bootlegger was trying to sell this super, super secret collaboration shirt between Megadeth and Lamb of God. You can get that. There's a link in the chat here. If you're watching, you're lucky because you can get this. After, there's only a few, and after they're gone, they're gone. So, you know, good luck, and thank you again for supporting a good cause. All right, man, it's time for us to almost be done with this Metal Stream of the Year. But before we go any further, we're going to travel to Tennessee to hang with an idol turned friend, a metal legend, an icon, and I love him so much, Dave Mustaine from Megadeth.
Hey now, I got one of my favorite humans in the world, my hermano. I lovingly call him a tío of mine, Señor Dave Mustaine from his home in Tennessee. What's up, brother? Man, I want to give you a hug right now, Dave. Looking at you right now and having your attention, I just want to hug you, man. I'm sorry. I'm guilty.
You strange man.
Hey, dude, it's really good to see you, man.
Thank you. You too.
I recognize this room from a lot of the cool videos that you put out on the internet over these last many months. I've seen a lot of cool, fun videos and performances in this room. Is this your office in your home studio, in your home?
It's my little office, yeah. It's not my studio. The studio is the house next door.
And, yep, I remember talking about that too, and I know you guys have spent a lot of time in there. But before we talk about music and studio, let me ask you, Dave, how are you doing, man? How's your health? You look awesome. Your hair's out. You've got the, you know, the Dave energy and the fire. I can feel it with this Zoom video here. How are you doing, Dave?
I'm all right. I'm okay. Getting by. Yeah? You know what? I don't want to sound too glib with everything that's going on with everybody because, you know, the city, our state, our nation, the whole world for that matter is, you know, they're going through some really trying times right now. And I think it's really strange how, for me, how music is the one thing that always brings us together. You know, and I know that sounds like oversimplifying a super complicated problem, but it's weird. You know, you think about it, you know, there's you and I right now, we can for one moment just kind of put aside all of the bad stuff that's going on, and we talk about music just for a second. And then when it's all over, we go back to reality and face the fact that, you know, it's another day and just gonna have to fight to get through it. But I love being able to do music and be able to share it with people. And I think that being able to talk to you is really a fun part of my career, because there's not a lot of guys that do what you do at your level.
Well, Dave, you know, I love you. Even when I try to impersonate you on Liquid Metal, Dave, I've asked some of our friends from the other bands that were part of the Metal Tour of the Year if they've developed any quarantine skills. Have you learned anything during this time? Have you done something that you normally don't do while being quarantined out there in Tennessee, Dave?
You know, I would have joked around normally and said that Corona got in me and it died. But I think that given the circumstances, this isn't really any laughing matter. Although, you know, there's a lot of people who have numerous different aspects and points of view on this. I myself tend to think the best point of view for me is to look down and to the left a little bit and play it. And you know, there's so many people out there that want to tell you how to live. When you're a parent, how to parent, you know. And there was a song that was on the radio when I was really young, and this guy says he can't even run his own life. I'll be damned if he'll run mine. I think it's almost called Sunshine or something, right? And I think about it a lot to be given advice to a lot of people, you've really got to have your act together, you know? So for me, I kind of toned that whole thing down and really started focusing on the music again. And it's made me have a lot more fun playing. I got to tell you, this new record is As Justice, man. It's shredding. I think you'll like it.
Dude, Dave, I love Dystopia, and that came out, that won you guys a Grammy Award, and being there to see you win was an honor. To be there cheering on, being the loudest voice in that room when you guys got that award. But I hear from the guys, you know, they're super excited to get into the studio in Tennessee soon to work on some new Megadeth. Can you give us an update, Dave?
Sure. Well, Dirk and David Ellison both just finished their parts. And this was probably one of the strongest records we've ever had as far as duration. The other records we've done have all been different lengths, and our contract states that we have, for one company it's 8 songs, for another company it's 11 songs. So realistically, all we need to do is do an 11 song album and we're done, right? So that's not the way old Uncle Dave is, though, you know that. So we got in the studio and we started working, and it got to where we were writing all the original parts, and we had 15 of them. And then we got to the end, and I said, "You guys, we didn't think about the cover songs, man. We had a couple cover songs that we wanted to do for this record, and damn, we forgot. What are we gonna do? Do you want to still talk about it? Yeah, I want to talk about it. Yeah, I want to talk about it. Everybody wants to talk about it." So we ended up doing 18 songs all together. And then we had another song that we forgot was part of one of the other songs. So we had 19. Ditched one of the singles that was the solo, the cover song. So now we've got an 18 song album we're going to be bringing.
Wow. And so where are you guys going, Dave? What kind of direction? I mean, is it just Megadeth? Is it, you know, I mean, where are you guys going this time?
I think this is probably in the top 4 records as far as towards the tip of the spear with our career and everything that we're doing. It's up there with Countdown, Rest in Peace, and probably Peace Sells. I don't know. The other one I would say is Dystopia. So that would round up my top five. And honestly, you know, it's kind of lame when guys have new records and they go, oh, this is my favorite one, because please, we all do that. You know, we have a new record come out. This is my favorite one ever. I mean, this is a good record, but I don't even have words to it yet. So
I was going to ask you, like, where are you going to go with lyrics on this one?
Boy, there's a lot of stuff to sing about, isn't there?
Yeah, there is. Yes. Yeah.
But I think I'm going to kind of keep it to myself right now and try and focus on finishing my guitar parts. This is the first time in a really long time that we've had a record that the guitar playing and the bass playing was so hard that we had to stop in between parts. And, you know, again, ask Ellefson. You know, he's the best ambassador when he's done with his guitar parts, because, you know, he's playing the same thing I'm doing. And we did some really cool stuff. Like, there's one part in one song that he played parts in it like Five Magics. And there's another part where, it was full on Take No Prisoners and just shredding on bass guitar. So you'll have to sing for yourself. You know, the guitar playing could totally suck, but I don't think it will.
Oh, never, man. No, we the world can't wait, and we can definitely use some new Megadeth music. I'd like to say, on behalf of all the fans, dude, we are so grateful and happy that you're here with us, laughing, smiling. You know, we were all concerned, but the world, dude, the world came and supported you and lifted you up and your family. And I'm sure there was so much just positive love and attention coming, whether it was text or phone calls or social media commentary. Like, dude, the world loves you, Dave. And we're so happy that we're going to get another sick album from you guys, man. Yeah. And before we let you go, dude, I know part of this Metal Stream of the Year special is showing full streams from the four bands that were a part of the Metal Tour of the Year. You guys, Lamb of God, Trivium, and In Flames. And now we're going to get to one of your sets that you guys did at St. Vitus in Brooklyn, New York, dude, about 4 years ago. I heard about this set. I wish I was there. I just moved to California, so I missed the timing. But, dude, tell us about that set, Dave, in the tiny location, killer place, St. Vitus in Brooklyn.
It was amazing. You know, I have a big portion of my heart has been carved out to New York ever since I first went there with Metallica and then returned with Megadeth. As soon as I reformed, it was one of the places, as quickly as I could get back there, was to New York and San Francisco. And I got to tell you, we're going to try and get the fans the best representation of what it's like to be at a concert by actually hearing this little tiny venue. Now, it may not sound real good to you guys over the stereo because it is small, but it'll give you an idea of the energy and the camaraderie too, because there's so many people and we're so close to each other and hanging out. And I honestly have people standing close enough where they could pull my socks up or down, whatever the case may be. I was that close. Or if they were little bastards, they could have tied my shoes together. But we were just having the best time. So there you go, the St. Vitus Bar and Megadeth.
I love it, man. Well, thank you so much, Dave, for hanging out with you. Nothing but love and respect to you and your family. And we'll see you soon, mi hermano. Much love, Dave.
Igualmente.
Orale.
Man, I love Dave Mustaine from Megadeth, and I love you too, man. Thanks to Anders from In Flames, Matt from Trivium, Randy from Lamb of God, and of course, Senor Dave Mustaine from Megadeth for hanging here on the Metal Stream of the Year. And I want to thank you for being a fan of all four of these bands and a fan of heavy music in general. My name's Jose Metal Ambassador Mangan, and I'm out of here. We're going to leave you off now. The end of our broadcast is a full set from Megadeth that was captured live 4 years ago, 2016, at the world-famous metal venue bar in Brooklyn, New York, called St. Vitus, man. An intimate performance with Megadeth. Metal Stream of the Year, we're out.
why we started this whole thing. Even though it's a hell of a lot hotter and we're a little bit older, it's still just as fun.
We haven't done one of these since, like, Cryptic Writings.
It's not Megadeth, it's Rick and the Rattlesnakes. Good evening, everybody.
Here we go. never take me. Gives me a migraine headache. And down to her level. I just keep on thinking it's my fault. Get insert to a kinky distance. Mankind has got to know. His limitations.
Thank you guys for coming down and joining us tonight. This next song that we're going to play for you, we were actually nominated for another Grammy this year for this next track. Alright, this song's called Dystopia.
Yeah.
you all for coming down and joining us tonight. I hope you guys had a good time coming here tonight. It's good for us. It's nice to remember where this all started. Many, many years ago, this one and me, we came out here in a motorhome. We played at a place called Lemours. And thus started the love affair between Megadeth and New York City. And it wasn't that much longer after that that this song was written. And this song, as a matter of fact, is very poignant right now. If you look around what's going on all over the world, this song means just as much today as when I wrote it. The song's called Holy Wars. Droogies, listen, I want to thank Dick and the Rattleheads for coming down and playing with me tonight. Officially introduce you over here, lead guitar, Kiko Lurero. And behind me on the drums, Dirk Verbjorn. Over here, you know him, bass guitar, David Ellison. We'll see you guys tomorrow night at Webster Hall. Fill the cracks in.